My dear friends in Christ, may the blessings of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you today and always. Amen. The greatest sound in our church and in the world is the laughter of children, the joy that children bring to us. Our children teach us how to love God purely, how to live joyfully, and how to walk in faith no matter what the situation is. This week, we were reminded again that our children in the United States are under attack by hatred, by rage, and by violence. 17 more lives were ended this week at the Marjorie, I'm going to write this down because I know it's a long name, I won't forget it, the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. I remember, and maybe some of you do as well, the first time that something like this happened. It was at a place called Columbine High School. That was in 1999, when two students went in to the high school and killed 12 students and a teacher. You might be shocked to know, since 1999, how many shootings there have been in schools in the United States. Elementary schools, middle schools, high schools, universities, and college. We know about the ones that the news has reported to us. We know about Columbine, and we know about West Nicolines, Pennsylvania, where the Amish schoolgirls were killed. We know about places like Virginia Tech University, Northern Illinois University, Sandy Hook Elementary School, and we know just recently about the school in Kentucky, in Marshall County, Kentucky, that was only a couple of weeks ago, and now more lives have been taken in a murderous bloodbath. 17 more lives. I don't know when it's going to end, but I hope it will end, because 208 school shootings in 19 years is 208 too many. You can look that up on the internet. These five or six that I lifted up were the ones with the highest fatalities, but there have been 208 school shootings in America since Columbine in 1999. What can we do? I think the most important thing we can do is to pray. We pray for the victims. We pray for their families. We pray for their communities. We pray for our country. And we pray that God would heal us and help us to live in love and in joy and in peace, and never to take up weapons of violence or hatred or anger against another human being. It is appropriate this morning that as we walk into the season of Lent, this first Sunday of our Lenten season, we have someone who shows us how to get through the brutal times of life, the extremely tough and gut-wrenching days and moments of life. We have our Lord Jesus, who faced hatred and rage and threats and intimidation and, yes, death for us. And we have him before us this morning in this gospel reading from Luke. And always on the first Sunday of Lent, the story is the same, just told by the different gospel authors over the three-year lectionary. But this year we're in Mark, so we hear Mark's version. So it is the temptation of Jesus. And this is a story that's framed on two sides, the temptation by other things going on in the life and ministry of Jesus. And there is a lot of Holy Spirit activity in these verses. So we have the account, which we just heard about 7 weeks ago, of the baptism of our Lord. So what happened on that day? Jesus was baptized by John. It's a joyful day. The Holy Spirit comes down from heaven and blesses him. And God speaks and blesses him as beloved. That was a joyous Holy Spirit-filled day. But what does that same Spirit do right after that? It drives Jesus out into the wilderness for 40 days to be tempted by Satan. And Jesus made it through those 40 days because the Holy Spirit blessed him and guided him through those days, and God provided angels to take care of him. The Holy Spirit was with Jesus on a glorious day, the day of his baptism. The Holy Spirit was with Jesus in his most difficult days, in the days of his temptation. And what happens at the end of the story? When Jesus comes out of the desert, he doesn't take a break. He immediately is driven by the Spirit to a ministry of proclamation. John's been arrested. He's in jail. He can no longer do that proclamation of God's kingdom publicly. So Jesus is again Spirit-driven to proclaim, "The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." Those were hopeful, Spirit-filled days. I'd like you to think with me about how the Holy Spirit drives you, blesses you, leads you, and guides you. Jesus stayed faithful and strong in his life and his ministry because he was blessed as a Spirit-driven person. You and I have that same blessing upon us. We are called beloved ones of God. We are called to serve God with all that we've got, with all the gifts and the talents and the joy and the grace that we have. We too are Spirit-led, Spirit-driven people, and we will never tire of proclaiming the good news for all the world to hear, that you are beloved, that you are a child of God, and that all you have to do is repent and believe in the good news. I'd like you to remember three things, three blessings as Spirit-driven people. The first is that God always loves you. The second is that Jesus always walks with you. And the third is that the Holy Spirit always does the leading if we can get out of the way. Especially on this day, I want you to share this message with the children that you know. Whether you have children right now that are young, whether you have children that are older, children that are out of the house, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, I want you to share this message of blessing with them. What I'd like to do right now is I'd like to invite, we have a lot of families missing today because tomorrow is a day off of school and people are traveling. It always happens at St. Mark's that way on these long weekends. But I'd like to invite the families that are here that have children, please come up and join me. We want to add a blessing to you this day. On this week when we've been reminded again about fear and hatred and violence, we want to add the blessing of God upon you and your children. So if you have children, grandchildren, if you please, come up, join me around the front. Maggie, come on. Come on. You can do it. Mary, come on with you. congregation to add a blessing with me on all of your children, and if you feel it is appropriate, please place your hand on your child's or the person next to you, their shoulder, as a sign of blessing from God. So I'm going to ask the congregation to repeat this blessing with me. It's very easy, but it's just great words for our kids. You are loved. You are loved. You are saved. You are saved. God goes with you. God goes with you. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your many blessings to us. Thank you for calling us to be your children. Bless these children. Help them to know, these children and youth, help them to know that they are loved, that they are precious, and that they are safe in your care. Bless these children and their families, and all the families of our church, and all the families of the world. Help us to live in peace, and in faith, and in love. We pray it in your name. Amen.